So now today we'll start ergonomics for beginners with special reference to industrial design perspective. Now if we for this if we look a picture from our life that says that a horse cart is carrying a upside down boat and a man is on its top. So this is a need we can say because it is also being used to. Now the figure raises some issues like is this the correct way of transporting? Is the man safe here? Is it a need? Then what can be done to stop this practice or to continue? If we need to continue this practice, if there is a need in somewhere, then what can be done for that? Now, we can say that do we need to design a horse cart for this purpose? Suitable to carry a boat with a driver seat somewhere here, so that the driver can drive this cart? Then there some question comes, what would be its seat design and other things? Do we need to develop a modular design that can fit the cart carrying capacity? Like the cart can carry some other material if it is necessary, then this type of goods like boat and that type of big item can also be carried. Then it comes, so many issues are there from the horse capability point of view, from system design and requirement point of view, from the man, the user's his point of view, whether he is feeling okay, comfortable to use this whole system or to perform with his full capacity. Then we can say that yes, this is a need. So we need to fulfill this need. Then is there any limit? How far we can go to solve the problems? Then development to achieve efficient and quality life. Now, for what type of quality we are looking for? That gives you comfort or safe operation, or you can increase your performance that with the full efficiency, that is that to use your own facilities whatever you have to its maximum possible ways, or to do certain activities within your limitations. Now we can see another example. Now here you can see that a road, it is around 2 kilometers straight in length, and this is the matter where a bullock cart is seen here. From this end, when it comes to this end, it comes with a full loaded. Then this man sits here and drives the bullock. Means he has to take care of his material, whatever he is carrying on his cart. But while going back after unloading, this man takes rest and the bullock goes back alone. Now I happen to ask this person why he does it. Then he said that, sir, while going back, we don't need to look after anything because the bullock is a very well trained. He knows where to go and how to go, and he walks in the same pace. But then if this bullock cart transport goods on the stretch of this road, while loading the man drives it, and during return journey the man takes rest. On inquiry, he replies, "Train bullock knows the job, and unlike human, it takes the same route repetitively." Now, what is the unlike human? What is the difference between human behavior and the animal behavior? If we look into these aspects, then a lot of solutions it can come up in our ways. Unlike pet animals, human is ever creative. Now, we cannot follow a certain route blindly. We always judge, ask why I am doing this thing and how we can make it better, and do not prefer repetitive and monotonous task. Always in creative mood to explore newness, initiative and invites problems thereby, because he is always trying to do something new, and while making this new things, unknowingly some problems he also invites. Thus try to solve the issues again, and thus continues the process, and this is the human life. Now, this is the development in human life. Now, there are loopholes are also there. How far we can use our this body and our mental capabilities to adapt to the newer challenges. So, thus technology comes, and due to technology advancement, our life makes life easy and comfortable, easy going and comfortable. But if this technology does not match with our requirement or our body size, mental ability, physiological tolerance limit, then this technology we cannot say that it is easy or comfortable. Now, the thing is that now the accessible to accessible to easily available ready mades. Now, when we are making ready mades, it may solve someone's requirement, but other may not like that, it may not suit to them. Then what would be our approach to have a common platform or with basic information about humans that can be used so that maximum number of people can be benefited? More and more dependent on machines, that is our life going on. So, where we should match our compatibility with machine output and man's input, and that feedback system, that is a subject that we need to study, and that is the ergonomics. Now, by this way we can say that the progress, now we know that from this ape to this, this is the progress is happening, and while in this progress, so there are many constraints also we have invited. Now, progress leads complexity and hazards that every time we meet. There is a constant struggle to adapt changing environment with newer ambitions and lifestyle aids with limitation of human capabilities that lead to hazards and stress, and it creates our errors. Now, fatigue and stress management and our lifestyle. Now, stress, it can be both good and bad. While optimum stress enhances performances, excessive stress has disastrous consequences. the stress level is intensifying in the face of stiff competition from rising economies day by day. The conventional definition of work, play and sleep is gradually changing in order to adapt our newer lifestyle. Now, people also work in various time schedule, such shift work irregularities are also in place. And this leads to fatigue, which affects our performance and the productivity relevances. So, now how we can solve this matter and what it does now? This will ultimately lead to an increase in human error and accidents, and that we are facing every day in industries, in our day to day home life and in our normal activities. As such, there is a need to manage our stress early. This early means if we know the information sufficient advanced in time, then while making some design or some technical output or technical advancement, we can utilize this properly, then it will be within our control. Now, if we take this figure as such, it says that a person is standing on a table, is in an office cabin, and he is changing that this tube lighting. Now, after seeing this picture, many thoughts are coming in mind. First thing is comes that this activity is unsafe, so safety is a matter. Then comes when he is standing like this way, he has to look upward. So, this postural problem, neck pain and back pain etcetera are there. He experiences the static muscle problem in these regions, so neck problem and a shoulder problem. And as he has to put these two edges here in fixed position, so here, so the time it takes. So, to just to fit this tube light, it takes a lot of time and it raises a performance efficiency question. It takes lot of time. Then occupational hazard, he may fall down, slip. So, there are many group concerns, they can give suggestions to improve this whole area. Now, it we can say that from design point of view, if we see, then it comes in these two corners, mostly what's happened, this is the two corners where there is a cut out spot is there, and of this tube light the two electrodes are there. That electrodes needs to be fitted in these two slots, but these two slots it happens not to be in a same position always. So, if this is at your eye level, then you can check it and you can change the thing as you require, but when it goes up your head, then it is very difficult to see these two corners at a time. So, quite often it is seen that when this side is horizontal, this is not in the similar way in horizontal position. So, means it remains in different positions. So, there is a trial and error system to put in to fit these two electrodes into those two slots. So, this is the problem. So, now from design point of view, after studying the whole activity pattern here, we come down to a problem that if we can solve something here that quickly we can fit in. So, this type of a development trial was made. It is that this is a clip kind of thing, it may be fitted here like this way, fitted here, and with this sides are the main electrodes fitting place. This is the gap here and this is a clip. So, just keep your tube light on this, so that what happens, your tube lights will appear like this way, will like this, and then you just press it, so it will have a click fit. So, quickly you can put it that is two tube lights and fit it. So, by that way that we can see this whole area from design point of view, and while doing this exercise or this solution, we have tested all the possible solution areas from the human point of view, means his activity point of view, his physical point of problem, his psychological or mental performance facility point of view, and his physiological tolerance point of view. Means what happened? So, we have tested all the ergonomic aspects and then we try to give some kind of design solution, and this area of study is design ergonomics. Now, the in this whole module, whole course, we will stress on this subject from various point of view. This is the ergonomics. Optimum use of human resource to achieve maximum benefit for his own requirement and to overcome multiple risk factors. What are the risk factors are here? There is the physical, physiological and all other mental behavior oriented. And now, in this whole course, we will try to give an overview of this, explaining all the different domains of ergonomics, but the stress will be on industrial design issues. Now, the design basically looks to the human aid to lifestyle. When our lifestyle changes to support that new designs we are developing day by day. But the matter is that if it is not properly used, then it gives malfunction. If misused, then it gives hazards and it makes troublemakers. Now, design looks into aiding and facilitating harm to the human natural ability, so that we can extend our activities that is limited in our natural body, and the means and methods of human information and application in such endeavor is the area of ergonomics. Now, the designing a product, a system or jobs must give maximum comfort, efficiency and safety to the users, taking into account differences in human performance and limitations. The work, the environment and the tools are designed to improve efficiency, quality, satisfaction and more importantly to eliminate human error and fatigue. So, how we can do it, that means and methods we will discuss in following classes. Now, if we see this is an industrial activity. Here he has to stand on an unstable stool. He has to look into this aspect, what is happening here, and then he has to fit the material, and his working posture is also bent. And so in this there is some problem we can face it here. Another point is that in this figure, this man, while concentrating on this work area in a standing posture, he cannot get a proper view. So he has to squat to get a proper view here. Then what can be done? We cannot change the man, but whether we can modify this working area, that height, or maybe some viewing clearances, means we can design this machine itself. So now the whole performance here, performance depends upon machine design and its function, work methods, workstation layout, and human efficiency. Now, what are the factors that reduces the human efficiency? If we know the human activity pattern and other limitations, then it can be decided on new development strategies. Then in this case, what to do? It requires to understand compatibility factors and application. Compatibility factors between the machine, the environment, and the man, the prime system component. Its compatibility has to be there, and it has to be both way dialogue. Then on what compatibility we are looking into? This compatibility in terms of physical structure and dimensions of the human being. Human beings' behavior, that is personal and group, some behavior, it depends on individual to individual, and there is some set of behavior that depends on, or that is followed by a particular group of people. So that is a stereotype and etcetera. So that we need to understand and application in a proper way. And finally, the physiological endurance and safe limits. See, if we do some activity and while doing that, if it crosses our physiological limit to perform that task, obviously we will feel fatigue. So what will be the endurance limit and safe limit? If we can recognize it, then the activity will be reduced. And this is the ergonomics and human factors scope. This is the ergonomics and human factors that we are going to discuss. Now, if we see the syllabus, now I am just reading the syllabus, though it is already given. The ergonomics for beginners with specific reference to industrial design perspective is that first overview of ergonomics and design relevances, man the prime system component, man machine environment interaction system and user friendly design practice, human compatibility, comfort and adaptability, fundamentals of ergonomics. Under this we will discuss physical, that is anthropometrics, human body structure and function, its posture, movement and biomechanics. Under physiological, mostly we will discuss on work physiology and psychological aspects, that is behavior, cognitive aspects and mental workload while doing certain activities. Now, information processing. In this section, under human processing, that is that information processing, that human error and risk perception, visual performance and visual displays, environmental factors influencing human performance, occupational stress, that is safety and health issues, ergonomics criteria and check while designing, design process involving ergonomics check and ergonomic design evaluation. Means after developing certain design, we have to evaluate it whether it really performs the expected task. And from ergonomics point of view, the how to evaluate this and the participatory ergonomics aspects means ergonomic. It is not only while developing something that all the informations and suggestions will be given to the users. Instead that in that developmental process, how we can make those users or beneficiaries directly involved in that development process, so that it whatever they are developing, it will be sustained though that experts or that expertise are withdrawn. So, how to make the participatory approach for any kind of development, that we will discuss. The above will be discussed with stressing industrial design perspective. Now, the whole syllabus will be discussed in under 5 modules. Now, these modules again are totally divided into 10 modules with total 40 class distributions. Now, under that the modules, the first module introducing ergonomics and content details, there will be 2 classes. Now, this first class, it is the introducing what is going on. Module 2, discipline approach, ergonomics and human factors, here around 5 classes will be there. Module 3, a human physical dimension concern, here how to measure the human body dimensions and its statistical applications and its design application, that with covering this aspect around 7 classes will be there. Module 4, posture and movement, here around 8 classes will be there. Module 5, behavior and perception, 5 classes. Module 6, visual issues, 2 classes, specifically visual ergonomics aspect. Module 7, environment factors, that is heat, humidity, ventilation, vibration, etcetera, then it will be covered with 1 class. Module 8, it concerns ergonomic design process, there will be 4 classes. Module 9, performance support and design intervention, there is 5 classes. And module 10, the design ergonomics in India, what is the latest position in India, in which institutes are doing what type of activities and etcetera, and where we are going now, and the scope for exploration, there will be one last class as a concluding class. So, by this way, total within the plan is that within total 40 classes, this will be over under 10 specific modules. Now, this is the current session is the module 1, that is introducing ergonomics and content details. Under this class 1, that is the current one, we are discussing introducing ergonomics and content details, that we are covering overview of ergonomics and design relevances, brief of the subject matter and industrial design, the course syllabus just now we discussed. In next class, we are going to discuss design today, what is the status today, human aid to lifestyle, and through this we will see man the prime system component, will explain this, and man machine environment interaction system, this will stress on it. Now if we see the total, the beginning of the slides, now we can go back just as an review what we have discussed today. It is that we have discussed today with one event or one picture from our life, and what is it, the need for that, the need justification. Then another example we discussed, that is that behavior aspect of man and animal. Man needs always to do something new. He does that when he feels some problem, he tries to solve it again, and by that a total developmental process is going on. Then we have seen how the development is creating our problem. So we have to wisely select the developments, whether that meets our requirement or just as a new things we have to accept, and we need to adapt ourselves in that system, or as we need our requirement we have to invent or we have to invite the development as it suits to us. So we need to see the different compatibility factors, the different compatibility factors, physical, behavior and physiological figures, and this area is the ergonomics. So today we have discussed this, and now next class we will see the design today, human aid to lifestyle, man the prime system component, man system environment interaction system. So now finally we expect after the whole class is over we may learn the quality design, the aspects of that, and that is through ergonomics issues, and that is the design ergonomics. So wish you good luck. Next day we'll meet again.